then we go to the thermal stability. We talked about this already, right? The condition of the atmosphere. So this is height and this is temperature. The atmosphere can be classified into different categories or different stability, unstable, neutral, and stable. And how we differentiate this is dependent on the temperature profile. For if unstable, the temperature profile is like that, where with height, the temperature decreases. That means that the surface is hotter than aloft. For neutral, is the temperature roughly the same with height. And for stable, the temperature is hotter at the ground and colder at the ground and hotter in the aloft. So if the temperature profile is like that, then it would change the condition of the atmosphere. One way to quantify this, instead of having a graph to show you this, you see it's visually that one is unstable, neutral, and stable. But let's say you just have a parameter, you look at the difference in temperature with height. Like this. So basically, okay, you feel like this is a derivative, right? It's a differentiation, so something to do with mathematics. But actually, it's just a difference. So you just measure the temperature at the bottom, at the ground. You just measure temperature somewhere above, maybe 10 meters above. Then you have the 10 meters height. So this temperature minus this temperature, divide by 10, then you get the temperature profile. But you can't just do it for one height. You have to do it for multiple heights. Then you average that and get the temperature profile. Because it's not, I think in environment, it's not just like that, right? It's probably like this, right? So you're going to depend. Like say if you are measuring here, and then you measure here, you might say, oh, it's stable. But actually the general trend is that it's going downwards, so it's unstable. So you have to take a few readings. And then basically it's just when you plot this, then you have something like that, then you can get an average temperature profile. But then if you just measure for one, then you might have a wrong interpretation of the atmosphere. But the concept is simple, it's just a temperature difference with height. If it's more than zero, if it's a positive slope, yeah, more than zero, it's stable. If it's about zero, although it will never be zero, exactly zero, right? There will be some temperature changes. About zero is neutral. If it's negative, right, less than zero, it's unstable. This is the effect of the stability on the dispersion of the plume. Maybe you've seen this before. So stable to unstable. So if stable, you notice that it doesn't spread out so much. When it reaches into unstable conditions somewhere here, then it starts to be well mixed in the atmosphere. So over in stable, there's weak turbulent mixing, but in under unstable condition, it's strong turbulent mixing. This one also, you've seen this already in the form of a video instead of just this. So unstable, you see that looping structure. For neutral, coning. For stable, fanning. The intensity of turbulence means for this, intensity is low. For unstable, the intensity of turbulence is high. So here is the diurnal variation of the boundary layer over land. So this is a bit more detailed than the diagram just now. This profile is for this region. This profile is for this. Well, this profile is for this. The y-axis is z, height. The x-axis is this is temperature, or specifically it's called a virtual temperature. It's a temperature that's not affected by water content. But just think of it as temperature. This is also height with temperature, height with temperature. You notice the variation is different between the regime. So for this one, you see the temperature profile, it starts to decrease, then it becomes straight up, and then when it goes up to the free atmosphere, this is the profile. This is for, so this is the surface layer at the bottom. Next layer, see what happens to the temperature profile. Free atmosphere. So distinct temperature profile values, trends. Then during the night, You know this surface layer, residual stable boundary layer, residual layer. What happens to the temperature profile? It starts to be positive, stable, and then here is slightly here is still straight up, something like mixed layer. See the mixed layer straight up? This is residual layer, straight up. But notice that the height is smaller. This one up to here, this one becomes smaller, and this is stable boundary layer, and the free atmosphere is about the same as the free atmosphere here. And then in the early morning, the stable boundary layer becomes, starts to, I think, this whole layer here starts to be suppressed downwards. And then this, when it suppresses downwards, then this one changes back to this. So you can imagine that stable boundary layer is zero, then starts to increase, then it's suppressed, then becomes this again, and that continues every day. I also noticed that the free atmosphere here is higher above ground during the day, but during at night, the free atmosphere, the nocturnal low-level jets and so on, those strong winds above, starts to come closer to the ground, because this layer is smaller. Now remember, okay, so this one is still this one, but this one is this one, and this one is this one. So this is not the early morning, this is actually in the middle of night, close to morning. So notice this and this, this and this, this and this, right? And this one, same thing, except for when it starts to change from night to day. This, 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 here. So you see, okay, it was suppressed. Then from mixed layer, the stable boundary, the residual layer, then it becomes mixed layer, residual layer. And then change back during the day, mixed layer. About the same thing, it's just that now it's just focusing on the removal of the stable boundary layer to become the mixed layer just for this early morning section. And when I say early morning, it's not like from 6 to 11 o'clock, it's like 6 to 8, very short period. Start to change very quickly. Maybe within half hour or within 1 hour, it starts to change. It doesn't take that much of time. So this is a time when it's quite interesting to see how the stable boundary layer, the residual layer, changes to the mixed layer quite quickly.